doing it here. Today is Saturday, February 13th, 2016. And it's a beautiful day up here in Gilpin County. Feels like, dare I say, a nice little taste of springtime up here. It's just so nice here the last couple days. Haven't been able to make a video for a couple days because for a couple weeks, a couple weeks ago, Dingo hurt his leg. I mean, it wasn't too bad, but you know, sometimes dogs can be babies, man. But yeah, he's had this recurring injury on his left ankle, his left front ankle, and I think he hurt it when he was a pup. So, what's up, buddy? This black dog, I don't know where he came from. What's up? Come on. And, yeah, he hurt that. He hurt that again. He just, sometimes he'll jump over something, land on it wrong, and next thing you know, he's like yipping and limping around. So, he was down for about, I didn't really take him out for like almost a week after that. And so, and then that was last week. The weather was it was pretty bad, so I didn't make a video. So here we are, man. And it was so windy, you know. I tried making a video for the last couple weekends, but it was so windy, and I was on vacation after my probation, so I just said, fuck it, no videos, here comes the wind, as soon as I said that, oh, that's hilarious, but, yeah, lots happened in the last couple of weeks, but, as you can see, Dingo's doing better now after that. Luckily, he wasn't too bad. You know, I had to carry him home quite a ways. So, yeah, obviously he's doing a lot better. But sometimes, yeah, that's like a recurring injury with him. He hurts that, and then he limps around for a couple days. Luckily, it's nothing too serious, obviously. It would affect him permanently or anything. So, yeah. There's been some interesting stuff going on since the last video. A lot of stuff. I got done with probation. Nice, man. Well, there's that windy. Start trying to talk. The video gods are just against me. I'm gonna muscle through this one way or another. Force my way through it. But yeah, I'm on probation, man. It's awesome. It's just kind of still sinking in. It's been over 2 weeks. Dingo, get off the ice, Dingo! Get off the ice. Ice has gotten to be where it's getting dangerous again. There's a hole over there. So, yeah, what's going on? The Broncos won the Super Bowl. That's kind of interesting development. I didn't see that one coming. Out of nowhere, really. They really had kind of a ho-hum season. Well, you know, they did all right, but you know, they won a lot of ugly football games with their defense, is what it was. You know, I don't talk much about sports here, my blog, but that was kind of cool, man. That was kind of cool here in Denver, here in Colorado. And it does good for our whole atmosphere around here when the Broncos do well, it seems. the economy's better, people are in a better mood. Life's a lot happier. When they lose, I remember that year when they went and lost to the Seattle, like 58-8 or something, man, that was terrible. People around here were pissed, beyond salty, like angry, mad. Like, I don't even want to talk about it, don't even mention that shit. Like, okay, whatever, man. It's just a game, man. No, whatever. No, whatever. So, yeah, that was big, huge development here in Colorado lately. It's still probably the number one story here in Colorado that we had the big parade. I remember going to the victory parade back when they first won the Super Bowl, and that was pretty, man, loud. It was pretty loud down there in Denver, I remember. It was pretty raucous. Good time. Oh, Dingo, say. Hold on. Gotta corral my dog. See, I remember watching on the news right before, you know, the week before the Super Bowl, how the Denver police are ready for the Super Bowl, you know, like, all over the place, had extra cops in place and ready to shut down roads and riot gear and tanks and helicopters, freaking all kinds of weapons and all this shit in case there was a riot, you know, and how they were going to be out in force dealing with DUIs, I don't know. Yeah, always, every, you know, just like everything else, like I emphasize, I've been emphasizing on my videos over the last year how every time something happens, it's like saturation DUI checkpoints everywhere. You know, I've noticed in my lifetime how that's just, you know, grown every year, man. As this police state grows, every event, Even the Super Bowl's not here in Denver, they still got freaking DUI checkpoints all over Colorado. Yeah, of course. Even if Denver wasn't playing in the Super Bowl, they had them all over the country on Super Bowl Sunday. It's a big day for them, you know. It's like any other holiday, pretty much, where a lot of people are out having a good time, and it's easy pickings. The popo, even though they know, man, you know, it was funny I went to an alcohol class a long time ago when I got my second DUI, and the teacher was telling us about that, how it's kind of interesting how every holiday people know there's going to be DUI just checkpoints out there, but they go out anyways and get arrested. You know, it never fails. Every year, it's still, and I guess it still goes on, man. People know there's going to be DUI checkpoints, but they go out and drink and drive anyway. It's kind of interesting how that goes, how that happens. Why do they get to that point where they just, you know? I remember when I was younger, I drank and drove all the time, and it was, you know, I never got caught for a long time before I even cared about it, you know. No one really cares about it until they get their first one, you know, their first DUI. Now it's like, don't do it. But yeah, it's kind of nice to be out probation, though, man. Really nice, man. It's like still sinking into me that I don't have to wake up every morning and make a phone call to see if I gotta go take a UA that day, or yeah, but then I don't gotta do that no more. It's awesome. So good. And then when I first got off, man, I smoked a little weed that first day, man. I tell you, I got a good night's sleep, man. A lot of, you know, I've noticed that, you know, so it's like, since I've gotten off probation, I've kind of been doing an experiment on myself to see, you know, how going back onto cannabis would help me, you know. And no doubt about it, man, using cannabis, I feel better. Pain of my arthritis pain's a lot less, you know. Used to, like, at night, my shoulder would start hurting and shit, and I'd have a hard time sleeping, you know. And tell you what, I've been sleeping a lot better now since I got back off probation, able to smoke cannabis again. Like, so, man, in a lot of ways, I can attest to the medical benefits of it. Really, a lot of ways, it's been helping me, like sleeping better, feeling better, and less pain. Appetite's better. Oh, you just, it goes on, and I've been having a few beers. Well, I got my kegerator going, which is pretty fucking nice. So that's working out real good, you know. I think I'm actually drinking less beer than I would if I didn't even have a kegerator. It's like, so always have a beer there whenever I want one. Don't have to worry about going dealing with bottles and shit. And save quite a bit of money buying the beer by the keg, so that's pretty cool so far. I'm enjoying that. Man, I just gotta be careful, man. Now that I'm off probation, man, you know, gotta, like, just don't be stupid. Fuck around and end up back in the system, man, you know. Every time I get through over it, and I'm done. You know, they always say, I'm never gonna get in trouble again, man. Never gonna do it. That's why I walk a lot. But yeah, don't get caught back into the system, man. It's not hard to do, though, man. So many things now that can get you in trouble, you know, for nothing. Just, you know, driving's the number one way they fuck with people, you know. So you gotta be real careful under the circumstances which you drive and don't drive, basically. So yeah, what else, man? I haven't really been paying attention to what's been going on over the last week or so, as I've been on vacation for a week, where the weather was kind of crappy that whole week. So I just kind of hung out around the house, did some housework, played some games and shit, fucked around, just relaxed, basically stayed warm, man. Tried to stay warm for a week and I'd have to deal with no cold weather, you know. It was kind of a nice reprieve from the winter. Just kind of get out of the winter for a week and just try to stay out of it, basically, is what I did. And enjoy my newfound freedoms after my probation was over. So that's why I took a vacation at that point. And just, you know, a week to just kind of kick back and reflect on, you know, being over it. And now I'm just trying to get back on with my life again. So it's kind of what this video is about, man. You know, I've been kind of paying attention to what's going on with the freaking election, fucking bullshit, fucking, what do you call it? Melodrama. What it basically is. Fucking Trump fucking being a big baby because he didn't win the Iowa caucus or something. And then fucking, and there was, what's his name, Ted Cruz, fucking rubbing it in Trump's face because he won the caucus. And then there was Bernie Sanders, all fucking one that basically tied with Hillary Clinton, which basically is a win for Bernie Sanders. So he's on a roll, I guess. I don't know. Hillary's all fucking freaking out, flopping around like a fish out of water. So is Donald Trump. Oh my God, oh my God. I guess today the latest thing was he's gonna sue him. Yeah. So yeah. Yeah, Donald Trump is thinking about suing Ted Cruz. It's funny, man. It's a fucking hell of a drama they got going there, man. Fucking totally scripted, total distraction to the people, to what the fuck's really going on. Who knows? What's really going on behind the scenes? I know the stock market is taking a steady fucking decline here in 2016. I've been noticing that. It's been going down, 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 down. And then it kind of creeps up for a day or two. No one's paying attention. It down, 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 down. Kind of like it all started back in like September. Uh-huh. That's usually when it always starts. After the summertime, you're heading into the fall. And it's just been... And it kind of... balances out over the holidays. It doesn't do much, and then as soon as 2016 hit, it just started dingo tanking again. Hold on, stay. Freaking a lot of freaking traffic around here. God, I hope I was recording all that time. Anyways, yep, market's been sucking here in 2016, and you know, it just keeps going that way, seems like. So when you think maybe it'll stabilize for a while, then starts fucking dropping again, and make sure we know about it, man. It's like I like to listen to the radio and shit in my car. They're always letting us know what's fucking when the stock market's tanking. Ding, 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 ding. They have the fucking stock market bell and shit. So, yeah. It's beautiful up here today, though. It's like, definitely feels like springtime. You can tell we're on the spring side of the winter. I'm gonna stay away from the pond for now. But, yeah, so I try to get back into my normal routine of trying to make the best video I can every week. I know some weeks are better than others, but, yeah. Anyways, thanks for watching, and we'll talk to you guys soon.